What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Weekend Drop. I'm your host, Joe from joesdaily.com. This is the series where I feature products and news that I found interesting this week in varying categories such as gear and technology, travel, food, booze, style, and so much more. I like to think of it as a way to kickstart your weekend with a little inspiration. This week's video will be a tad bit shorter than usual just because I have another interesting video coming up for you guys and I'm gonna focus on that. But without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first piece of news I wanted to cover today falls in the entertainment category and actually has to do with Netflix. Now, I don't know if you've ever thought to yourself, I wonder what the most searched show is in all of the United States. And even further, I wonder what state I live in, like what are people searching for most? For example, I used to live in California. What do they have over there? And now I live in Illinois, and what's the most searched here? So a company by the name of High Speed Internet apparently did a deep dive into Netflix's analytics and actually came up with the most searched rankings per state in the United States. And if you can believe it, The Umbrella Academy was the most searched overall. Now, I watched the first season of The Umbrella Academy and I thought it was a good show, but I started watching season two and I kind of just lost interest pretty quickly. Maybe I gotta give it more of a chance to win me over, but I wasn't a big fan of season two, at least so far. And I know a lot of people disagree with me because I know people talk about it on social media all the time, but I still didn't think it was the most searched in the United States. If I'm being honest, I thought Black Mirror and Stranger Things would be the most searched, but apparently I'm wrong. Now, if you look at the map they put together, as you can see, it breaks it down by state. You know, I'm born and raised in New Hampshire, so to find that New Girl was the most searched was very interesting for New Hampshire. And then, of course, I just left California after living there for 17 years, and I'm definitely not surprised Black Mirror won the award for most searched there, because Black Mirror was definitely a hot topic when that was trending. You know, every time a new season came out, it was always trending in California, for sure. But yeah, as you can see, you know, you've got Ozark, which is making a play a few times, Schitt's Creek, of course. I personally thought Tiger King would dominate, but I'm just wrong, I guess. I didn't think Umbrella Academy was gonna take over as much as it did. I mean, it's got Florida, it's got Texas. I mean, it's everywhere. So yeah, I would love to know what state you live in and what's the most searched show in your state. Why don't you leave it in the comments below? All right, product number two is gonna be falling under the style category, and it's by a company by the name of California Cowboy. Now, they reached out to me with gift guide options for the holiday season, and they showed me a bunch of their products, and I was very intrigued. The thing that caught my eye the most was they had these men's and women's robes that were really cool looking, and I kind of wanted to get my hands on one. So I reached out, and they said they would send one of their yukata robes, and I got to choose which color and which size, so let me just show you what they sent me. Now, the print you see me rocking here is called the Garibaldi, which is just one of the prints they offer for the yukata robes that they sell. And the other one's called the Wedge, but I'll show you that in a second. Now, obviously, their whole angle was to create this luxury poolside attire. Obviously, I'm not gonna be swimming during the fall or winter time, and I now live in Illinois without a pool. So for me, this is really just a cool robe to lounge around the house in, read my morning magazine with my coffee and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm loving it. It's super comfortable and warm. And the best part about this, actually, especially if you are by the pool, is it actually has a beer bottle pocket. Unfortunately, I didn't have any beer to show you this, so I'm just gonna show you with a hot sauce bottle. But yeah, it's right in the back right side, kind of right above your butt area. It's just like a cool little feature. So the California Cowboy Yukata robes will run about $148 USD. And one of the things that's really fun about it is because, you know, their whole thing is that they're trying to create products that are kind of like conversation openers. Like if you saw someone wearing this robe out by the pool, you're probably gonna be like, hey, that's really cool. Let me know more about that. And that's kind of their whole angle, is they're trying to create products like that. And it's not just their robes. Like if you look at their other products they sell, which, you know, I'll leave the link down below so you can check them out. From my understanding, every purchase, because this is what they sent me, comes with a beer koozie, which obviously has the California Cowboy logo, comes with this really cool, attractive gold bottle opener, which would be pretty cool to have poolside as well. Excuse the text message while I'm filming. And then they also give you these conversational cards. So for example, on one side you see it says californiacowboy.com, and the other side says pardon the party. And then this one is the odds are good, but the goods are odd. And once again, californiacowboy.com. And there's more, but they send you these. These are just great like conversation starters and you can hand them out. And I just think it's genius, like their kind of whole branding angle with their products. So yeah, huge shout out to California Cowboy for sending over the cool swag. I really appreciate it. And if you guys wanna check out their robes, maybe you see this being a good gift idea this holiday season, links are down below. So the third product I want to feature is going to fall in the food and drink category, and it's from my friends George Dickel Whiskey. More specifically, the Cascade Hollow Distilling Co. And it's this beautiful bottle right here. Now, before I get more into this, I just want to point out that I have a long history with George Dickel Whiskey. One of my favorite press trips I did a few years back was to Tennessee to actually go to their distillery. They are one of the coolest brands out there and one of the best whiskeys I've ever had. To this day, I still buy bottles whenever I see them. And they're not like super expensive. I mean, they do have like limited edition runs and whatnot, kind of like this. But truly, they are very good whiskey. So they're great for gifting as well, because anyone that's a whiskey aficionado, if they haven't tried George Dickel, they're gonna love it. Now, this whiskey was specially crafted by their general manager and distiller, Nicole Austin, which, by the way, Nicole Austin, I have met her before. She's badass. So I was super excited to hear about what they're doing with this. Actually, I don't think she'll remember me because it was from a while ago, but I do remember really having some really good conversations with her. So I'm super excited for what they're doing with this series. So the Cascade Moon Edition number one I have here is the first of hopefully many from the Cascade Moon Whiskey series. Those that are true whiskey fans will like to know that these are gonna be highly limited. So definitely something once you actually have in hand and you try yourself, you're gonna be happy to just sip on this little by little so you can savor it for hopefully years to come. So for those interested in what the tasting notes are, because I'm not cracking this bottle open just yet, I'm actually gonna do a full review on joesdaily.com, but I'm just gonna kind of read what they gotta give for the tasting notes and all the kind of like the stats that people like to know about whiskey. First and foremost, this is 11-year-old whiskey, and they're saying it offers a savory pretzel-like note along with bright and fruity notes of raspberry, pineapple, and coconut. It's 84 proof, so of course it's encouraged to sip again and again to taste its unique flavors. So, some bad news here, though you probably can find it for someone to maybe ship you a bottle. Currently, the way it's stated is that the Cascade Moon Edition number one will be regionally available in Tennessee, California, and Texas for a limited time. So I am very fortunate for them to ship this to me in Illinois to do a proper review and tasting. So thank you so much, George Dickel team. I love you guys. And just so you guys know, if you are interested in buying a bottle, it is being retailed or recommended retail price at $89.99 USD. So that's it for the products. Let me end off with the giveaway as I do every single Friday. I didn't want you guys to think I forgot about you, because I didn't. So this week I'm going to go back to the $10 giveaway to the Cash App. Basically, to enter, all you got to do is make sure you subscribe to the channel, like the video, and leave a comment down below. Don't forget, when you do leave a comment, leave your Cash App username so I can actually send you the $10. And you'll know when you get it, because you'll probably get a notification on your phone. If you are not signed up for Cash App, it is free. I put a link down below so you can easily sign up. If you have a smartphone, you should be able to sign up pretty easily. And then, like I said, if I pick you, I'll give you $10. And just as a reminder for those that are maybe are new here, whenever I gift someone $10, I also do an equal amount to the charity of their choice. So if I pick Susie Smith and she says she wants to donate to Charity Water, then I will donate $10 to Charity Water in addition to giving her $10. That's it for today's video, guys. Once again, sorry it was shorter than normal. I am going to be doing a cool video unboxing very soon. So, well, if all goes as planned, I will be doing an unboxing soon, which is why I had to shorten this video just a little bit. As always, if you guys want to follow me on social media, you can find all my links down below. Everything is at Joe's Daily, and that's it. I'll see you next time. Peace.